Hello students, today our topic of discussion is electrostatic deflection. A general arrangement for electrostatic deflection is shown over here in your slide. There are two parallel plates with a potential applied between them. These plates produce a uniform electrostatic field in the y direction. Thus, any electron entering the field will experience a force in the y direction and will be accelerated in that direction. There is no force either in x direction or z direction, and hence there will be no acceleration of electrons in these directions. The deflection sensitivity of a CRT is defined as the distance of the spot beam deflection on the screen per unit voltage. If L total is the total amount of deflection of the spot beam on the screen for the deflecting voltage VD, then the sensitivity can be expressed as S equals to L total by VD. Okay, now first of all everybody will note down the figure in your copy by pausing the screen, and then you will proceed further because you have to do some calculations. So after you have completed your drawing, we will proceed. S equals to the separation between deflecting plates. These are the deflecting plates and S is the separation between them. P is the distance between the plate and the screen S. P is the distance between the plate and the screen. This is the screen. So this is the difference. L is the length of each deflecting plate. L is the length of each deflecting plate. Okay. VD is the deflecting voltage applied across the plate. VD is the deflecting voltage applied across the plates. Okay. M is mass of the electron. E is charge of the electron. Small v is the velocity of the entering electron. This should be small v. Okay. And VA is the accelerating anode voltage. Clear to everybody? Now, the loss of potential energy when the electron moves from cathode to accelerating anode, we can write small e into capital VA. Okay? And the gain can write as half mv square. Now, equating the two energies, we get VA. From there, we can write V square equals to 2 EVA by m, or small v equals to root over of 2 EVA by m. Now, force active deflecting plate is F into S. Okay. F into S equals to E into VD. VD is a deflecting voltage applied across the plate. So, from here, F equals to E into VD by S. Right? Now again, you can write that if small f is the acceleration of the electron in the y direction, you can write m into small f, that is mass into acceleration. So from there, once capital F equals to E into VD by S, and again capital F equals to small m into F, mf. So you can write mf equals to EVD by S. Clear? Hence acceleration. From here, you can find F equals to EVD by MS. Okay. Time taken by the electron to move through the deflecting plates is T equals to small l by small v, l by v. Therefore, the upward velocity acquired by the emerging electron is small vy equals to F into T. Okay. So, vy equals to F into l by v, putting the value of T. Then again, you can put the value of F and you will get Vy equals to this value of F. You will get EVD by SM into LYV. Okay. Where capital D is the distance traversed by an electron, U is the initial velocity, F is the acceleration of an electron, and T is the time taken. Okay. As the electron is starting from rest, the initial velocity is zero. That is U equals to zero. And the distance traveled by the electron, capital D, is L2. Okay. Substituting this value of capital D in the expression for D, from the formula of mechanics, we get, that is, you know, the equation that S equals to UT plus half FT square. From there, if you write that, or many times we say S equals to UT plus half FT square. Huh? So L2 equals to, as U is 0, half FT square. Okay. As D equals to L2. So substituting the value of T, we get, already we have find out the value of T from here. So we get L2 equals to half F L by V square. Okay. And again, putting the value of F, From here, putting the value of F, you will get EVD by 2 SM L by V whole square. Okay. Now, tan theta equals to VY by V. Come into this diagram. Here, if this is the direction of VY, this is V, and then this is the theta, then what will be tan theta? VY by V, right? So, tan theta equals to VY by V. VY is L1 and small v is P. Okay. VY is the L1. What is VY? VY is the velocity in the upward direction. That is the L1. Okay. And V is this P, V. VY, that is L1. And this V is the P in the X direction. Clear? L1 by P. Now, L total equals to L1 plus L2. Again, to the previous slide. L total equals to L1 plus L2. Okay? L1 plus L2. So, if you put the value of L2 and L1, from this equation, you will get this one. Put the value of L1 and L2, you will get this equation. Okay? So, from here, you can write that capital L equals to L by 2 plus P. So, you can short this equation as L total in I capital L VD by 2S into VA. The rest things remains the same. Only you are substituting capital L in this place. Okay? So, what you can write that the L total equals to ILVD by 2S into VA. Okay, so write down for a given accelerating voltage VA and for particular dimensions of CRT, the deflection of the electron beam is directly proportional to the deflecting voltage. Okay. This means that the CRT may be used as a linear indicating device. The discussions here shows that VD is a fixed DC voltage. The deflection voltage is usually a time-varying quantity, and the image on the screen thus follows the variation of the deflection's voltage in a linear manner. The deflection is independent of the E by M ratio. In a cathode ray tube, in addition to the electrons, many types of negative ions such as oxygen, carbon, chlorine, etc. are present. With electrostatic deflection system, because deflection is independent of E by M, the ions travel with the electrons and are not concentrated at one point. Hence, cathode ray tube with electrostatic deflection system does not produce an ion burn. Now we will find out the deflection sensitivity. The deflection sensitivity of the CRT is S equals to L total by VD. Put the value of L total and the VD, that is IL by 2S into VA. VD is cutting out. Okay. Meter per volt. The deflection factor of the CRT. The deflection factor of a CRT is defined as a reciprocal of the sensitivity. So, it will be just opposite. G equals to 1 by S. So, 2 SVA by small L into capital L volt per meter. Okay. It is clear that the sensitivity can be increased by decreasing the value of the accelerating voltage VA. But this has a disadvantage of the luminosity of the spot is decreased when with decrease of the VA. What is the disadvantage? As the luminosity of the spot is decreased, with the decrease of the VA, the accelerating voltage will be decreasing. On the other hand, a high value of EA produced a highly accelerated beam and thus produces a bright spot. However, a high accelerating voltage requires a high deflection potential for a given deflection. Also, highly accelerated beam is more difficult to deflect and is sometimes called hard beam. So, I think it is all about electrostatic deflection. You have got a clear idea about electrostatic deflection. If you have any queries, ask me through WhatsApp or email. Thank you.